What's up, Train 2.0 Nation? It's Jason down here in the corner here, and you might have thought this was a video about Connor McDavid or maybe Sidney Crosby, but this is actually a video about hidden asymmetries in daily life. Boom, boom, boom. Now, everyone knows I'm a bit of a nerd and crazy and technical, and this book here really inspired me. It's called Skin in the Game by Nassim Nicholas Taleb. And if anyone knows about hidden asymmetries, that's the idea that there are things, actions you can do or actions you can take that have more upside than you realize, than what kind of appears on first glance. This is actually one of the things that has pushed me to put more skin in the game for myself, to produce more content and to really show more of my process and what I'm doing, because I think there's a lot of coaches who don't have skin in the game and therefore aren't held accountable for the advice that they're putting out. I want to make sure that I'm accountable for the advice that I'm putting out. Now let's get to that advice. We're going to take a look here at McDavid, and in particular we're going to look at what he's doing and what Crosby do very similarly when they pick up the puck. This is a hidden asymmetry that you can use in your game. Now when I say hidden asymmetry, it's also, you could also use the term 80-20. You could also use the term optionality. And what I want you to take a look at here is when McDavid picks up the puck. He does this often, and you're going to see Crosby do this as well. When he picks it up, he does it inside of a crossover and a C-cut. So as the puck's coming to him, you can actually see he's on an arc headed this way. And as that puck actually touches his stick, he's going to C-cut off his left foot. I'll show you that in a sec here. So there's McDavid picking it up. I'll back it up for you. This is on the power play. He's coming back in the zone. And you can see he's picking it up on a crossover. That's how he's picking it up. But then the movement I want you to pay really close attention to is this right here. It is this movement as he picks it up. We'll go back a touch. Watch his left foot. As he picks it up, there's that. There's this C cut. Now, if you guys have just been living in the YouTube world, I just did a podcast and a blog talking about the skate profile. So the podcast is called The Train 2.0 Show. You can check that out on iTunes and Anchor and Stitcher and Google Play, wherever you watch your podcast or listen to your podcast. And what I talked about was how the rocker of the blade allows you to, if you tilt it over, causes you to be on an arc. So you can watch here, I'll back it up again, but you'll watch that when McDavid tilts his foot over, and because of the rocker of his blade, the way it interacts with the ice, it puts him on an arc like that. So I'm gonna back it up again just to hear. And so you're gonna see he picks it up on a crossover, and then he picks it up on an edge there like that. And that allows him to be moving laterally with no tension in his system as he's picking up the puck. And what we can kind of deduce from this clip is that his lateral movement opened up some sort of forechecker who is coming at him, and it caused him to go the other way. I'm going to show you this kind of this inside edge pickup with Sidney Crosby. So let's take a look here at what Crosby does on the pickup. Now, the difference is rather than picking it up off his inside edge, you'll see him picking it up on his outside edge. So he's on an arc like this. And this is such a subtle thing. So you can see he's on an arc there. That sets up his dangle one way. So we'll go back. We'll show that again. So you can see him, even though he's skating in a straight line here like this, the puck comes to him, and as he picks it up, not after, but as he picks it up on an arc, and that causes this defenseman to move this way, and then he gets to go that way. Watch this again in tighter. He's skating in a straight line this way. As he picks up the puck, he moves on the angle. And if we go back again, and again, he sets up that dangle. If we go back again, you're going to see how he gets on that outside edge right here. And this outside edge, again, because of the profile of the blade, interacts, how it interfaces with the arc. And listen to my podcast and read my blog article, traintubono.com/blog. I'll link to that up there. Because of this arc, it allows him to pick it up like this, and it gives him way more options, and optionality, meaning more options, is an asymmetry. Now, I think a lot of people are going to watch this and underestimate just how important this is, and you're also going to underestimate just how technical it is, because a lot of people think that it's just a matter of turning or doing, I don't know. I think people underestimate this all the time. I welcome you to be skeptical. I really welcome that. And we'll see a few more good examples of it here with McDavid, just how much he is moving on an arc as he receives the puck. I invite you to be skeptical, but I also invite you to look at top players like McDavid, like Kane, like Barzal, like Crosby, and then compare that to third and fourth line players in the NHL. There is a difference. There is a skill gap too. So again, you can see it there. Just the how much on an arc McDavid is picking that up. That is a hidden asymmetry. That is an 80-20. That is one of the key things you can do to improve your time and space when you're picking the puck up wherever. It takes some mechanics. You really need to learn some of the mechanics before you can do this. And by that, I mean the ability to relax your legs and relax your edges, that kind of thing, as you're moving left, right. This is something we call the magic mechanics. And this is something that I teach in the Train 2.0 membership area. And you can check that out. That's kind of like a condensed version of everything I've learned as a kinesiologist and professional hockey player. But if you don't want to sign up and become a member, that's okay, because I have all my stuff all over online. You can Google it. I have it on the blog, train2.0.com/blog. I've got the podcast, all sorts of stuff for you guys to look at, all sorts of resources. So if you'd like the condensed step-by-step version to make things happen quicker, there's the membership for that. And otherwise, I have all my free resources that you can use to study and learn exactly what I'm talking about. I hope that you find this helpful, and please drop me a line if you're able to use it in a game and it works. I'd love to hear your feedback. And like I said, I also invite you to be skeptical because I like to put my skin in the game, and I'd love to know if I'm wrong. Thank you so much for watching today. Hope this helps. We'll see you in another video.